Hello guys, welcome to miniProject. In this miniProject, we are going to measure mass of Earth using Arduino. Okay, don't freak out. We are not going to build some galactic or huge weighing machine and place our Earth on it. We are not going to move our Earth, but instead we'll use some simple indirect method to measure mass of the Earth. But first let's look at what all things are you going to learn from this mini project. So you'll learn a bit of Arduino coding, you'll learn how to use IR transmission receiver pair. So IR transmitter is IR LED and IR receiver is a photodiode. So you will learn about how to use them. You'll also learn to use a piezoelectric sensor. Then we'll also learn a bit about acceleration due to gravity. Now some of you might get the idea about indirect method I'm talking about, and finally we'll get to know the mass of Earth. So this is going to be our thing that I also learned a bit, and you'll learn from this mini project. So method that we are going to follow was generally followed by scientists who intended to find mass of Earth in early 19th century. So it used two equations, namely Newton's second law and Newton's law of universal gravitation. And if you substitute Earth's gravity g for the acceleration term, that is the acceleration due to gravity of Earth, and combine these two equations, we get something like this. So, and this small m is the mass of the object under test. So this m gets cancelled out on each side, and we can solve this equation for the mass of Earth. This symbol m, the subscript of plus in the circle, is the mass of the Earth. So by using this equation, that is mass of the Earth is equal to acceleration due to gravity into square of the radius divided by gravitational constant. So we'll assume that we know the gravitational constant, and we'll take value of radius of the Earth as like we'll know the value empirically. So by using this equation, we'll compute mass of the Earth. So we'll what is the thing that we'll measure from our Arduino setup? So by our experiment, we'll measure the value of acceleration due to gravity, this small g, and we'll consider these two variables as pre-known. So gravitational constant and radius of the Earth are the values that we'll put directly and measure acceleration due to gravity using experiment that we'll do. So next we'll look at what all things are we going to need to conduct this experiment. So we'll need one Arduino board, Arduino Uno or Arduino Dumilau or any Arduino will do. Then we'll need a USB cable that connects from Arduino board to the computer. Depending on your Arduino, this may also vary. So here I have a USB A to B converter, cable. Then we'll need few resistors, namely 4 560 ohm resistors and 200 ohm resistors. Then we'll need a piezoelectric sensor. I also soldered wire terminals, wire to this sensor. When you'll purchase, you'll get only this part. So this one is the positive terminal, and the outside plate is the negative terminal. So how this works is, when you exert the force on this, or you put some pressure on this, it will generate a voltage on, positive voltage here. This is the, with respect to this terminal. And how we are going to use it is, I'll explain it in just a few moments. Then we'll need one op amp. I'll be using UA741CN op amp. Then we'll need IR TX and RX pair. So this is a IR LED that acts as a transmitter, and this is the photodiode that acts as a IR receiver. Then we'll need one potentiometer, one breadboard, one PCB to assemble some circuit. I'll tell you which circuit we are going to assemble on this. Need some tape, few small wires, and three 1.2 meter long wires. Then cardboard. I will mention the use in just a few moments. Then we need one solder iron and solder wire. Now we will be assembling two circuits. One of them we will put it on PCB. So this is the circuit that we are going to put on PCB. Let me explain the structure of this schematic. So first of all, we have this 100 ohm resistor here. It's connected to the positive terminal of our IR LED, and negative terminal, that is cathode, is connected to the ground. So that is our IR transmitter part. Here we have another 100 ohm resistor. It's connected to negative terminal of photodiode, and positive terminal, that is anode, gets connected to the ground. So this photodiode is in reverse bias, and I will show you the particular assembly in how. So the situation is like this: IR LED should be in front of photodiode. So if it lights up, the light should fall on the photodiode. So that finishes our IR, TX and RS part. But output of this photodiode is not digital. So to make it digital, we use this op amp, 741 op amp in comparator mode. So what we'll do is we'll I suggest to just look up the pin detail of 741 on net, and we'll connect one potentiometer. Potentiometers, one terminal is connected to the VCC, another terminal to the ground, and the variable terminal is connected to one of the input of op amp. Other terminal is the output of photodiode. So if depending on which one of them is higher, output is given to Arduino board. So Arduino reads whether, so what happens is when there is a when light doesn't fall on photodiode, there is no current passing through this resistor photodiode assembly. So this terminal will be at higher potential, and as soon as light falls on this photodiode, current starts flowing, and this terminal is pulled down, and voltage on this terminal is reduced. So and this threshold should be in the middle of those two voltage range, the one when photodiode doesn't receive the light and another one photodiode receives the light. So depending on that, we'll get two voltage levels on this terminal, and we'll be able to detect whether there is something in between this photodiode or not. So what we'll do is the object under test, that is the object that we are going to that will do this free fall motion to measure acceleration due to gravity, we'll have some kind of thin notch on its top that will be initially between these two photodiode and IR LED. So light won't fall on the photodiode, and we'll come to know that our object is near this assembly. And as soon as it will start to fall, light will fall from IR LED to photodiode, and we'll be able to detect the starting of the free fall. And we'll assemble this thing on our PCB, and this is how it will look when we'll put it on the PCB. So the thing that was I was talking about, like they should be in front of each other. This is our potentiometer, these are our resistors, this is op amp, this is output terminal, this that goes to Arduino, and this is our supply. Here is the circuitry that we'll be assembling. So here we have four piezo sensors, piezoelectric sensors. We'll put them on a cardboard. I'll just show the assembly. It will look something like this, but let me first explain the circuit. So here are our four piezoelectric sensors put on the cardboard. I have some kind of covering on them, but these are the piezo sensors. So the negative terminals are connected to ground, common ground that comes from Arduino here, and their positive terminals are connected to our Arduino board. But there is one 560 ohm resistors in parallel with all of these piezo sensors. So what this piezo what those resistors are will do is they're called a button resistance. So what they'll do is they'll reduce the voltage generated by this piezo sensor. So they'll kind of load the piezo sensor. So what happens is when you when there's a knock on this piezo sensor, they'll generate a voltage spike, and that can be very high, around 70 to 80 volts, and that will damage our Arduino board, I mean input pins. So what we do is we reduce them by putting this low value resistance in parallel with our piezo sensor. So initially I kept 1 megaohm, but still the spikes were large, so I reduced it. So it's kind of as the internal impedance of our piezo sensor is high, so this resistors will load this piezo sensors and reduce the amount of voltage spike. So I mean this is a simple assembly, and this is how my prototype looks. I mean this is our Arduino board, and these are 4 resistors and corresponding connections. So here is an image of our assembled schematics that we have made in that I've shown in previous part. So here on top is our IR module. I have used the cardboard that I have shown to mount it on the wall. Then this is a signal wire that's coming down to our Arduino board. These are our piezo sensors and the piezo circuitry that I have shown already. And these are the 2 power wires going on to our IR module, VCC and ground, that is 5 volt and ground. So I mean, and from here we'll get the reading to our laptop on the serial monitor. So that's the whole assembly, and here is our 1 meter mark. So I have mounted this on the wall using this cardboard, and at the bottom there is this IR module. So I hope this assembly is clear. If you have any doubt, you can put it in the comment section. Now here is a small bit that I need to make here. So what's going to be our procedure? So let's say this is my object under test. There is a ball, and I'll be putting one small cardboard on top of it, and I'll be sticking that on the top. And what we'll do is we'll first of all we'll insert it inside this there's IR module at the top, right? So and it looks something like this. So the situation will be something like this. So that IR module on top will not be, that IR receiver will not receive the light, so it will read high on our module, high on our Arduino board. But when it will start falling, that is it will start falling from here, so the situation will be something like this. The ball will start to fall, and the photo will get the air light, and current will flow through the resistor, and that will lead low on the Arduino board. So that will detect the start of the fall, and the piezo sensor at the bottom, when the ball hits the piezo sensor at the bottom, this sensor will give a spike to our Arduino board that will determine the end of the fall. So the time duration between these two is the time of light, and we'll be using one Newton's equation to calculate the value of acceleration. But before we do that, I'll show you the Arduino code. Okay, let's go through the Arduino code. So here on top are 4 piezo sensor pins. Then we have photodiode pin. This is the pin that receives the signal from photodiode. Then there is this LED to indicate whether readings are, whether this photodiode generated proper value above threshold or not. Then this is a string to print the data on our signal monitor. These 2 things are of no use. I initially used EEPROM to store the data, but they are of no use, so let me just get them out of the code. Then we have 2 integer variables for start of the time and read time. These are the variables that will read the value of piezo. Then in the setup part, I'm just beginning 1 serial communication. I'm just setting up the pins, nothing here. Then let's go to the loop part. So what will this loop will do? It will take the reading of the photo pin. So if there is any obstacle in the IR TXRX path, then this value will read high. And I'm just lighting up the LED to indicate that there is a something in between them. Then this start time get updated every time there is a reading taken. Independent of whether it is high or low. But as soon as the start is low, that is, the thing has started falling, the digital pin is just made low to indicate that that has started falling. And this is not of any value in case of measurement, but this for our visualization. then I'll continuously read this for piezo sensors, and if any one of them shows the spike, then I just take out that store that time interval, and I'll just put it on the serial monitor, and this is just to indicate that we have got one reading. I'll just set one LED high, and again I'll make this start as high so that again it will start to take the, I mean that's again get into the loop. So I mean this should make it clear, and this time interval that we are getting here and time my start time is our time of flight. Next I'll show you how we'll use this time of flight to measure acceleration due to gravity. So we'll be using one of the Newton's equation, that is distance is equal to ut plus half at square, where s is the distance, u is equal to initial velocity, and it is going to be zero in our case because we are starting from rest, that is we are dropping our object under test from rest. Then this a is acceleration, in our case it is going to be acceleration due to gravity, and t is our time, that it's actually time of our flight. So as the initial velocity is going to be zero, this term gets zero, so s is equal to half, and I have replaced a with g, that is acceleration due to gravity. This is just change of symbol, nothing else, so half gt square, and we can solve this equation for g, and s is equal to 1 meter in our case, so g is going to be 2 into s by t square, where s is equal to 1, so it is going to be t 2 by t square. So that will give us the value of acceleration due to gravity. So now let's do our experiment and get the value of g.
Okay, so now let's do the experiment. I will just hold the one on the top and reset the controller here, and then I'll just leave. So what we get, we got around 443 milliseconds. Let's do it again. Again we got 443 again. This time it didn't detect the fall. Let's do it again. Okay, it detected 464 milliseconds.
Okay, so let's put those readings in the equation. So here let's take the average of those three readings. So we got 2443 and 161464, so that amounts to 450 milliseconds. If we put those readings into this value of t, we get g of 9.8765 meter per second. So this is the acceleration due to gravity, and then we'll put those values into the equation that I had shown in the starting of the video by replacing g with the value that we have obtained, replacing r with the radius of the earth, that is 6371 kilometer, we have to square it, and then divided by the gravitational constant, and that gives us the value of 6.0067 × 10⁻¹⁴. So this is the value that we have obtained, and that's the mass of the earth. Now let's look at the actual value of mass of the earth that is derived by various scientists by using different scientific methods, and let's see how close we got to that value. Okay, so now let's see the actual mass of the earth. Let's search Google for that. So it's the mass of earth, get around 5.972, and how much is ours? Ours is 6.0066 × 10⁻². So that's I think that's close. Let me know what do you think about this, and so thanks for watching this mini project, and subscribe to this channel if you don't want to miss any nice mini project that I will do in the future. And once again, thanks for watching. And even check out my previous videos. Thank you.